Thank you very much. It's indeed a pleasure to be here. To be here in the state of Madhya Pradesh and in Indore. Eminent gentlemen on the dais, ladies and gentlemen. First of all, I'd like to apologize for being late. Supposed to be here at 10, but in the morning I decided we let us gift a new destination to the city of Indore. So I went to this Patalpani. You must have heard of Patalpani. We traveled on the train right from Patalpani to Kalakand. It used to be called Kalakund, but I started calling it Kalakand from today. And we have decided that this section from Patalpani to Kalakand will be retained as a heritage section. It was an old demand which I had made to the Ministry of Railway when I was in the state as Managing Director of Tourism in 2008. Finally today I cleared it myself. So we'll have a rail bus operating on that section. The section will be totally restored to its heritage value, and I think it will preserve the heritage of that place, providing a tremendous tourism destination to this already beautiful state of Madhya Pradesh, which is the heart of Indigenous India. And the DRM is also here, the DRM Ratlam is also here, and we have decided to make this operational. The special tourist packages between Patalpani and Kalakand by end December this year. And we will try to improve things by then, by end December, by 25th of December, and definitely by March, the full section will be made up into a wonderful tourist destination, but the packages will start in December. So that is why I am late today, because we had to work this out and do something and give something to the city of Indore, and that is what made me late. Well, I have spent a lot of time in this state. I was the managing director of tourism right from 2004-05, then 2006-2009, and the last tenure was in 2015 for about 8 months. Then we created Hanumantia. That was the last contribution to the state. So I know a lot about this state. I've been almost everywhere in this state. And I'd come here with a mandate to improve tourism and position this state at the forefront of all the states insofar as tourism is concerned. Well, we created a lot of destinations we created, we improved MP tourism properties. Everywhere, be it the Todiga Dhawa or the Hanumantia thing, the place at Churul, Maheshwar, Omkareshwar, Mandu, Bhopal, Jabalpur, Bargi. So we created a lot of destinations and we started getting the national award for being the best state in tourism from February 2008 onwards. That was the first time the state was declared as the best state in the field of tourism in the country, amongst all the states, and then it's been a continuous journey, and I think the last award also went to the state. So this is a wonderful state. I think the summit is not about tourism, but it's about leadership. So I switched from tourism to leadership, but actually tourism is a sector where I spent a lot of time in tourism. Started with my being the director of the National Rail Museum in about 5 years, running the world's oldest train at that point of time, getting a Guinness World Record in January 1998. Then switching to the mainline, Ministry of Tourism, Government of India. Then switching to ITDC, then coming to the state once and twice and thrice. And then again moving to Air India, which tourism is about travel. Travel in India means railways, and it also means the airways, it also means the roadways, started in the journey. The main focus was bringing about a change. And that is what life is all about, and that is what postings are also all about. Not being part of the status quo. Not indulging in the run of the mill. But making a difference. And that is possible almost everywhere. Leadership is often confused with great achievements. Perhaps leadership is also about great achievements, not totally about great achievements. It's basically about creating an environment where people give their best. And after you create an environment, you sit back and relax and watch people giving their best, changing things, doing great things. That is what leadership is about. It's not about me personally doing a Guinness World Record or bringing a state to the forefront of it. It's not just mainly about that. It's about creating an environment where things happen easily. They happen fairly easily. They are simple. Things are made simple. They are made so simple that they happen on their own. Change the processes, change the structures, change the cultures. That is what leadership is about. I took over railways sometime in August last year. The first thing that we realized was, given this organization requires a lot of reforms. Because among the things that are expected from this organization, and also from me, there are so many, in thousands, it's physically impossible to do them. Physically impossible to do them. They all appear very, very simple. साफ क्यों नहीं होती ट्रेन स्टेशन अच्छे क्यों नहीं होते ट्रेन कम क्यों होती हैं ज्यादा क्यों नहीं हो सकती रिजर्वेशन क्यों नहीं मिलता हम ग्रोथ से पेस नहीं कर पा रहे हैं हम जहां से लोगों को फ्रेट ले जाना है उनके लिए ट्रेन रेक्स नहीं दे पा रहे हैं हम उतना कोयला नहीं मूव कर पा रहे जितना हमको मूव करना है उतना आयरन ओर भी मूव कर रहे हैं जितना हमको मूव करना है लोगों को रिजर्वेशन के लिए जाए All these problems appear simple, but when you've got 50,000 of such issues, then it basically means it's a systemic issue, which can only be handled through a process of reforms. So what we did was, we embarked on this process of reforms. And reforms basically are of three types. One is cultural reform. Which every organization needs. And culture is the most important part of any organization. And that really decides whether the organization is going to achieve greatness or it's just going to be a mediocre, it's going to sink. Easier said than done. How do you do that in an organization? How do you start that in an organization which has 1.3 million men and about 30 corporates in that organization? It's not as simple as MP2000, which had only 2,500 men. Not like Air India, which has only 35,000 men, 30,000 men. How do you start in such an environment? And when you find it difficult to start, best is to start somewhere. Just start somewhere. Start. Don't remain confused. So how we make this start? Well, by putting a small, an A4 size sheet of paper, post outside my room, outside the door, we pasted it there. No bouquets, no gifts. That is how we start. started the cultural reform. No bouquets, no gifts, no frills, no protocols. And this message was sent right across the length and breadth of the country. Because radio stands everywhere, it's all, it is there everywhere, every village, every district is touched by radio. Every district is not, it's not everywhere. And then we started focusing on, we started, we said, yes, one very important point in the culture reform, and this I said everywhere, including the state, and including Air India, and including ITDC, and including the railways. For me, my passengers are not important. For me, my clients are not important. My staff, my men are much more important than my clients. And if I look after my men, they'll look after my clients. And if I say I'll not look after my men, but I'll look after the clients, then I'm living in a fool's paradise. It doesn't happen that way. It doesn't work out anywhere, whether there's a public sector or a private sector, anywhere. And that is what Richard Branson also said, the owner of the Virgin Airlines. My men are more important than my clients. So this was one message which we have been trying to send down all over. My staff has to feel a sense of pride. My staff has to feel motivated. My staff has to feel they are on top of the world. They have to feel that they are in a soup, the organization will care for them. They are in a problem, we will step forward and do that. This major change in life. Looking after your HR and being sincere about it, being genuine about it. Talking about integrity. Talking about corruption. Putting the issue of corruption back on the table. Well, we will not indulge in corruption. Nor should we allow anyone to indulge in corruption. It is the need of the hour. It is absolutely the need of the hour, because almost all interfaces, all interfaces which you have with the organized sector, with the government sector, they are not really good. This is an issue everywhere, cutting across. And unless you put this issue back on the table and start discussing it every day and start pushing it down, the people say, yes, this is important, this can't be just, we just can't put it beneath the carpet. We'll discuss it every day. Every meeting we'll discuss this. In every meeting we'll discuss the conduct of my men, the character of my men, the need to be the need to be good, the need to be caring, need to be honest, totally honest. Himandari se kaam karna. All these are part of the cultural things. They sound, quite often they sound bombastic. Quite often I feel ki aaj ke zamane mein koi ki baat hai. But if you want to make a quantum change, a quantum jump, want to create turnarounds, and these things play an extremely, extremely important role. Can I get a glass of water? These things play a very, very important role. I remember when I was in the Madhya Pradesh tour, so one of the things which we started doing was, we started organizing corruption conferences. You'll ask what it is, because even I also asked myself what it is. I don't know how to organize a corruption conference. It's a conference in which we have people like sitting here in the back offices, corruption in that organization. That is a subject of discussion in open forum. We started that. I'd done a miniature version of that in IT, and I was chairman of IT. You bring the issue of corruption back on the table. If all the stakeholders stick right there, and then you discuss corruption in the organization. The first time we had it, it was, it created waves in the city of Bhopal, we had it. And we had three sessions of that. The first session, we had all the stakeholders discussing in open forum where everybody said your organization is great, there is absolutely no corruption. And I refused to believe that, because it is not Ramdas which is going on. There has to be corruption. The second round, we had everybody from our organization out of the room. And then we discussed all the stakeholders, contractors, advertising agencies, all those who make money from our organization. And then some things came out. And the third round, we again had the third round, wherein it was, I was sitting in a switch room, and it was, everybody was mandated, nobody will go home till he meets me on a 1:1 basis. And I met each and every single guy on a 1:1 basis sitting in a switch room, and then they all spilled the beans. There was no means. The organization changed. It changed that day. These are all cultural things which are necessary. We have the person who is the leader of the organization. He has to look at that. It's not just merely about doctor or merely about delivery. Delivery is a symptom that will happen if I put everything right. The second thing which we are looking at is process. How do I do things? How do decisions get taken? How do contracts get entered into? These processes over a period of time have become extremely complicated. Changing those processes. Delegating authority to the functional level. Delegating authority is also very difficult in this country. Because here there is a lot of mistrust. हमको लगता है कि मेरे पास पावर है तो सब ठीक है मैं कुछ नहीं गड़बड़ करूंगा लेकिन मैं डेलीगेट करूंगा नीचे वाला पैसा खा जाएगा बट यू हैव टू द लीडर हैज टू ट्रस्ट हिज पीपल टू बिलीव इन हिज पीपल यू हैव टू टेक दैट Risk if there is. For delegating authority, we have the railways in the last 1 year, what we have delegated is more than what we might have delegated in the last 30 to 40 years. And now we are picking up processes, enlightening them, and trying to simplify them. But easier said than done, that is why it doesn't get done. Because there are egos involved, there are territories which are involved, authority which is involved, you cut down some of the authority and then repercussions and then people don't want to, they feel their importance will go down, all those problems are there. But process reforms are absolutely, absolutely essential if this country has to go forward, if organizations have to prosper. I'll give you an example from here. Majority of Air India in 2015, August, 1st of September 2015. And we had not announced an international flight for quite some time. The wrong thing we had not announced. I thought I should immediately announce an international flight, which is something very, very major for an airline to do that. So I looked around and I felt yes, a flight to San Francisco from Delhi would be great because the Bay Area in San Francisco that has a lot of Indians and there is a lot of movement. Having worked in tourism, I realized there is a lot of movement there. So I said, let us do that. And then somebody told me, yes, there is a proposal to that effect in the organization. The proposal has been going around for the last 7 to 8 years. 7 to 8 years. They have been deliberating on file, on paper, how many passengers will travel, what will be the revenue per passenger kilometer, what will be the expenditure per passenger kilometer, and ultimately they used to prove on the file that the flight will be in losses. That is what the planning and the financing were doing, because that was the process. That was the process to start a new flight, because rightly so, if a flight like San Francisco goes into rates, it's about, the flight is a 250 crore flight a year, it goes into rate, you lose about 100, 150 crores. So nobody was taking that decision. We changed the way new international flights used to be arranged. We just simplified the way that I'll talk to the ambassador of India in that country, ambassador of that country into India, the travel head in that country, the travel head here, and a couple of other people, and take a call to Chile. So Sat September, Dominic, I flight to Chile. Gave a one line order. He let us run this flight from the 4th of December 2015, and we moved ahead. And that was the people in my organization were asked, how can you start a flight this way? The chairman is from MP Tourism and from Railways, he doesn't know anything about how to fly aircrafts. The company is going to sink, there will be problems, the flight will lose. All these arguments are there, but then we started looking for the aircraft, and one of the aircraft which was in the hangar for a long time, we set that flight and we started that flight. That flight is a historic flight, it's the world's longest flight, and it ran full from day one. From day one it was full. It was one of the most important flights in the world, which even United could not think of, or nobody could think of such a long flight. And a country, a company which was in reds for the last, which had not seen an operating profit for decades, had managed to pull this coup. Because we had to energize the company. My men had to feel, yes, they can do something great. That flight made all the difference, and then we looked at connecting Washington again, the last flight to Washington had failed. That was a fear. We just did this rough calculation I did in my mind, and then we said, okay, let us go there, let us go to Vienna, let us go to Madrid, let us go to Stockholm, let us go to Copenhagen, let us connect Bangkok with Chandigarh. 10 flights in 1 year. We started 10 international flights in 1 year. Tanda to aise hota hai. Look, CEOs ho. Business to gut pe hota hai. Kabhi bahut calculation pe nahi hota, jo bahut bade bade businessmen aur successful, wo gut pe hi karte hain. Aur gut tab develop hota hai jab aap pura involved hote ho. If you are totally involved, your gut will tell you the right thing. So we started about 10 flights, posted operational profit for 2 years continuously. But the massive debt which was there that pulled us down, because there was no way I could have serviced that debt, the 50,000 euro debt. And then the problem with the airline expenses. Similar things happened every day. The one is, I have told you about the gut thing, which the leader has to have. He just can't say, somebody pakki pakai file, all the bubbles will be done on the file, and somebody should say, I'm going to keep this high and light, and find this is the best solution, and then he says, yes. That is not the way organizations, good organizations are. Second is key, another point is key that you all have to give outputs. For giving any output, any input is mandatory. You have to give inputs, only then the output comes. For outputs, getting output, inputs are mandatory. But every input does not give you an output, does not guarantee an output. And that is something which the top guy has to understand. In which quite often we don't, especially from the sector from which I am, from the Sarkari sector. It is never understood. Input diya, toh mere paas output na hai. Har output, har input output guarantee nahi karta hai, but har output ke liye input ki zarurat hoti hai. Jo aadmi isi ko samajh jata hai, bahut badhiya businessman banta hai. It is a tremendous business. You have to give a lot of inputs and finally the output will come. Provided you understand your business. Defining the outcome in advance. Starting with small things. You are from Madhya Pradesh. Most of you are from India. You relate to India. 2004, 25th August, when I landed in the state for my first posting, normally railway officers don't get posted to states. As a managing director of Madhya Pradesh Tourism, we had an office in Gangotri building in TT Nagar, fourth floor. A lot of expectations, because the then CM asked me to come here, I'd work with the CM to set right tourism in the state. Went and sat in that office in the fourth floor of the Gangotri Bhavan. Sick, Sarkari offices were kind of ganda sa. Gande parde, ganda furniture, safai nahi, logon ke chehre murjhaye gaye. He saw that. And we decided to improve that office. We had the first meeting. First meeting in the lift lobby of that building. Yeah, this was a sick building. I also felt miserable when I landed there. But the first meeting day with all the 150 staff over there. And I said, we are heading, our responsibility is to improve tourism in the state. If our office itself is so dirty, who will come to the state? Let us clean up the office. I asked them, they remained quiet. I said, again, repeated, let us clean up the office. How many days will it take? They said 15 days will it take. I said 24 hours given, let us clean up the office in the next 24 hours. Went back. That was 24th of May. 25th May I came back again there. Lift lobby, we gathered there. We asked what happened. They had cleaned up. They had cleaned up the office. To whatever extent they could not replace the furniture. They cleaned up the office. Totally clean. They're waiting for someone to tell them to do it. Nobody ever told them to do it. Then we said, let us improve the flooring, put granite on the flooring, thick paneling on the walls, get new modern furniture, piped in music, beautiful toilets. All my team was smiling away. कौन पागल आ गया है? बैठी आए कंपनी घाटे में चली 25 साल से. Finally, my general manager of finance, he stepped forward and he said, "Ki sir, मैंने फिर estimate बनाया, वही estimate. मतलब basic estimate should be made right there on the spot. हर किसी को works का मालूम होना चाहिए. तो जब 25 से 30 लाख का estimate बना, तो तब तक people बस्ट हो गया मान धमकार दिया सेठ की पैसा तो है नहीं क्यों नहीं है कहता 25 साल से घाटे में कंपनी थी 25 साल पहले भी नहीं थी शुरुआत से मैंडेट था स्टेट में टूरिज्म में ठीक करना तो हमने पूछा कितना घाटा होगा आपको डोंट रिमेंबर द फिगर नॉट क्वाइट ओवर 30-40 करोड़ का कुछ घाटा बताया 40 करोड़ का बताया जिला मैंने फाइनेंस कि 40 का घाटा तो सह सकते हो तो 41 का भी सह सकते हो कहाँ लिखा है कि 40 के ऊपर एक पैसे का घाटा नहीं सह सकता अगर 41 का हुआ तो वो भी सह हो 42 का हो तो वो भी सह तो थोड़ी बात समझ में मैंने कहा एक करोड़ का घाटा मैं कंसीडर करूँ तो वी सैंक्शन द एस्टिमेट देन द इंजीनियर वाज देयर बिकॉज़ दे वर डेड The organization was dead. जान डाल दिया। तो इंजीनियर ने पूछा कि काम कितने दिन में करो कहता कि पहले टेंडर करना पड़ेगा 3 महीने में कॉन्ट्रैक्ट अवार्ड करूंगा फिर होगा तो 6 महीना तो लगेगा मैंने कहा 30 दिन देता हूँ 30 दिन में कर दो कोई बिजनेस नहीं होगा कोई होगा ही नहीं होगा रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी मेरी कड़क आई साइन दैट 30 डेज चेंज इवन दो वी वर गोइंग टू शिफ्ट टू न्यू ऑफिस प्रेजेंट प्लेस में एक दिन मेरी कड़क 30 days भी चाहिए एंड देन पीपल स्टार्टेड फीलिंग कि यस सब कुछ हो रहा है फिजिकली सबको कहते ना कि हम आगे बढ़ रहे हैं ये हो रहा है फिजिकली दिखता नहीं ना चीजें तो लोगों को हमारे स्टाफ को फिजिकली दिखता है कितना एवरीथिंग इज एवरीथिंग इज हिस्ट्री दे रिनोवेटेड ऑल द ऑफिसेस एवरी सिंगल ऑफिस वाज रिनोवेटेड मेड एब्सोल्युटली कॉर्पोरेट स्टाइल एवरी सिंगल होटल वाज रिनोवेटेड वर्क Exactly corporate style in a sarkari environment. Target tha ki us shahar ka jo private hotels ko beat karna hai in terms of profitability. and we achieved that profitability. I achieved a profitability of about 45%, which is very high even for a private sector. We did build hotels, we built about 30 properties, and we built so many destinations we built. It turned into profits, better profits, center started supporting us, and we went. But even this to lena hi padega na, risk to lena hi padega. Kyunki logon ko dar tha ki kahin hum itna ghata ho chuka hai, kisi tarah se tankhaye de rahe hain, kahin ghata aur pad gaya to tankhaye utni bhi band ho jayengi. So CEO has to step forward and take that risk. The Madhya Pradesh tourism turned out this way. Sabji ke jo maine problem dekhi hai, because I've handled a variety of jobs. I have been very lucky that I worked in the railways, which is nobody from any service enters railways. Worked in the government of India for 5 years, I handled tourism for India. And it's the largest hoteling company in the country at that point of time, which had 34 hotels, duty-free shops, ITDC. Then Air India is the mother of all corporates. The experience was massive, cutting across sectors, I could see. But there are a lot of commonalities. मैंने कहा कि एयर इंडिया का सक्सेसफुल चेयरमैन बनने के लिए मुझे एयरक्राफ्ट इंजीनियरिंग का मास्टर होना जरूरी नहीं है, फ्लाइंग बिजनेस का ही मास्टर होना जरूरी नहीं है, होटल चलाने के लिए मुझे इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ होटल मैनेजमेंट का ग्रेजुएट होना आवश्यक नहीं है, होटल बिजनेस की जानकारी होना भी आवश्यक नहीं है, मेरे पास बेसिक फंडामेंटल लीडरशिप स्किल्स होना आवश्यक है. वो भी कोई स्किल नहीं है, ये नॉट स्किल्स, ये प्योर कॉमन सेंस कि आपकी टीम में जान होनी चाहिए, पूरी टीम में जान होनी चाहिए. मैं अपनी टीम के साथ कंपीट नहीं कर रहा, मुझे अपनी टीम का ख्याल रखना. दे शुड फील यस सीईओ केयर्स फॉर देम, वी शुड इट. एयर इंडिया में मेरे स्टाफ को एक एमपी ने झापड़ा मारा था, 25 झापड़ा मारे थे, तो हमने बैन कर दिया था उनको फ्लाई करने से. मेरी अथॉरिटी भी नहीं था, तो नो इन माई अथॉरिटी, आई कुड नॉट हैव डन इट, आई कुड हैव लैंडेड इनटू अ सीरियस प्रॉब्लम. बट मैंने कहा मेरे जहाज में नहीं चढ़ा गया, फाइनली नो फ्लाई लिस्ट बनी, नया रूल बना, ये अनूली पैसेंजर नो फ्लाई लिस्ट में डाला जा सकता है. उससे मेरे दिमाग में खाली बात है कि मेरे आदमी को उसने कैसे मारा, कैसे मार सकता. मेरे आदमी माना ना, मैं मारूंगा ना, तो और कैसे मार सकते, हरा हरा गया उसको मारने चला. तो यू हैव टू, दिस इज वन फंडामेंटल, योर टीम. सेकेंड वॉज कि आपने टारगेट कैसे सेट किया है. टारगेट कैसे, जब मैं एमबी टूर से आया था, मुझे 3-4 दिन बाद मुख्यमंत्री जी ने बुलाया और तो मुझे क्या कर रहे हो, छोटा रहे. तो एक्सपेक्टेशन वॉज कि मैं आपको बहुत बड़ी बात करूंगा, मैं साहब ये कर रहा हूँ, मैं जब टूरिस्ट सेंटर होता हूँ उसको आगे ले जाऊँ. हाँ, मैंने कहा दफ्तर ठीक कर रहा हूँ, फिर क्या करोगे, पूरा दफ्तर फिर पलाश को ठीक करूँगा और प्रॉपर्टी चेक कर. आई कुड सी द इरिटेशन, बट मैंने कहा ये सब कर लूंगा, उसके बड़े काम करूंगा, फिर राजनीति करूंगा. बट अगर मेरी छोटी छोटी चीजें खराब हैं और मैं बहुत बड़ी बड़ी बात करूं, तो इस बात में सामंजस्य नहीं है, बिल्कुल सामंजस्य नहीं. जब मैं डीआरएम दिल्ली बना, दिस वॉज डिविजनल रेलवे मैनेजर दिल्ली, मैं यहाँ से एमपी से वहीं गया था. दिस इज द बिगेस्ट डिवीजन ऑफ द कंट्री, 50,000 एम्प्लॉइज हैं, बहुत होते 50,000. मैं वेंट टू माई ऑफिस, मैंने देखा मेरा ऑफिस इतना गंदा है, खराब हालत में है, बिल्कुल सरकारी ऑफिस जैसा है, तो मैंने कहा पैसेंजर्स को साफ गाड़ी कैसे दूंगा, हाउ कैन आई एंश्योर क्लीन क्लीन ट्रेन एंड क्लीन रेलवे स्टेशन, आई कांट इवन मेंटेन माय ओन ऑफिस। तो पहले मुझे अपना ऑफिस तो ठीक करना चाहिए ना, ऑफिस की मशीनरी ठीक करनी चाहिए। अगर मेरे ऑफिस में करप्शन होगा तो मैं कैसे कहूंगा कि टीटी पैसे नहीं खाए, कैसे मैं रोकूंगा वहां पे करप्शन। तो मुझे अपना ऑफिस ठीक करना चाहिए, मुझे ऑफिस में करप्शन नहीं होना चाहिए, साफ सुथरे काम होने चाहिए। ये फंडामेंटल चीज बनी थी कि कटिंग अक्रॉस ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, सब ऑर्गेनाइजेशन कॉमन था, रनिंग ऑर्गेनाइजेशन जो लीडरशिप स्किल्स आर द सेम। हमको डिसाइड करना पड़ेगा, जैसे हमने 2006 में बताया कि 2008 में हम लोग बेस्ट स्टेट बनेंगे, जैसे 1995 में बताया कि हमें गिनीज वर्ल्ड रिकॉर्ड लेके आएंगे, तो गिनीज वर्ल्ड रिकॉर्ड आएगा दुनिया की सबसे पुरानी ट्रेन चलाने का, 1998 में आया ना, 14 जनवरी 1998 आई गॉट द गिनीज बाय कोरियर टू माय रेसिडेंस। पहले डिसाइड कर लिया था कि गिनीज आना है, विल गेट अ गिनीज, वी हैड डिसाइडेड इन एडवांस कि एमपी टूरिज्म को नंबर वन बनना है, एयर इंडिया में ऑपरेटिंग प्रॉफिट आने पहले दिन ही सेट कर दिया था कि विल गेट ऑपरेटिंग प्रॉफिट, जैसे दिखा देंगे कि कंपनी हम भी चला सकते हैं एज गुड एज द प्राइवेट सेक्टर। आईपीटीसी का टर्न ऑफ, अशोक होटल पोस्टेड 70% ग्रोथ, 70% growth in revenues in the year post 9/11, 2002-2003, which was the worst ever year in the history of hospitality in the country, that hotel posted a 66% growth in revenues. Just by willing it, just by saying it, this has to happen, just by sheer willpower, the leader has to have leadership, confident leader has to have that will, the tremendous will. But हम लोग उलझ जाते हैं छोटी छोटी technicalities में, छोटे छोटे processes में, और बड़ा vision खो देते हैं। The leader always has to have his vision in front of him कि ये मुझे achieve करना है, उसके लिए अगर छोटी छोटी चीजें भी set right करनी तो वो भी इसको करनी पड़ेगी। But he can't lose sight of the bigger picture at all, at any point of time. हर छोटी चीज़ जो करता है वो उस बड़े पिक्चर में फिट इन होनी चाहिए। I'll just tell you one incident of how we got the first Guinness. I became director of National Railway Museum in 1994. It was considered to be a sidey job. Because हम लोग की आदत होती है कि हमको इम्पोर्टेंट पोस्ट चाहिए, क्योंकि इम्पोर्टेंट पोस्ट से हम भी अपने आप को बड़ा समझते हैं, बड़े देखिए हमको that should not be known by the post which I occupy, the post should be known by who occupy it. It was considered to be a sideline job. And I was काफी लोगों ने अपनी गम जाहिर की कहाँ तुम बोले ब्राइट स्टार इज हैविंग गोन दिस पोस्ट दैट पोस्ट, मैंने कहा देखते हैं। एंड कई चीजें करी, द परसेप्शन चेंज इन द फर्स्ट सिक्स मंथ्स, बट देन आई डिसाइडेड टू सेट अ गिनीज वर्ल्ड रिकॉर्ड। ये एक फैसला था कि गिनीज वर्ल्ड रिकॉर्ड बनाएंगे, अब तरीका ढूंढ लेंगे उसको बनाने का। तो हमारे एक इंडियन खड़ा हुआ था, एक स्टीव इंडियन खड़ा हुआ था, 1855 का बेल, ओल्डेस्ट इंडियन इन द वर्ल्ड, उसके जस्ट मई 1995 आई हैव बीन टू म्यूजियम, यॉर्क म्यूजियम इन यूके, एंड वेंट फ्रॉम द यॉर्क म्यूजियम एंड देन द डायरेक्टर वाज शोइंग मी अराउंड, आई आस्क्ड व्हिच इज द ओल्डेस्ट इंडियन, ही शोड मी वन लोकोमोटिव कॉल्ड मेलार्ड विच वॉज द करंट रिकॉर्ड होल्डर फॉर बींग द ओल्डेस्ट लोकोमोटिव इन द वर्ल्ड, बिल्ड 1865। तो वहीं पे मैंने उनको बोला विल बीट यू, विल बीट यू, विल सेट अ न्यू वर्ल्ड गिनीज वर्ल्ड रिकॉर्ड बाय रनिंग द ओल्डेस्ट ट्रेन इन द वर्ल्ड, दैट इज हाउ इट स्टार्टेड। देन वी लुक्ड एट दैट इन was too big a thing कि मैं दुनिया की सबसे पुरानी ट्रेन चलाऊंगा, being a very junior officer in the hierarchy, not as a chairman but as a director with only 15 years of only 14 years of service. वो चली, वो ट्रेन चली, दो बार हमारे मंत्रालय ने उसको पूरा रोकने का भरपूर प्रयास किया, नहीं रोक पाए, चली, उसका गिनीज वर्ल्ड रिकॉर्ड मिला, वो द गिनीज वर्ल्ड रिकॉर्ड बाय कुरियर टू माय हाउस, एंड द गिनीज वर्ल्ड रिकॉर्ड केम टू आई, आई थॉट कि आई शुड, इट्स अ ग्रेट फीलिंग गेटिंग द गिनीज वर्ल्ड रिकॉर्ड, I filed 7 implications in my life so far. And I said I should show it to someone. I said the person to show it to is the chairman of the railway board. He is bureaucrat. Went to his room, barged into his room at 8:30 in the night, and I said, sir, please. He looked at that and he said, okay then. That day I realized I have to have my achievements for my own sake, for my own race which I am running, for my own satisfaction, not to impress anybody else. That was a great lesson. But he got the Guinness, which was a Guinness not for growing mustaches or fingernails or fads like this, but for a real technological achievement, running the oldest train in the world. So well, then I realized that you can setting Guinness World Records also not so difficult. If you are doing it, then we file a Guinness World Record for the Shani Bhopal and for the world's longest flight going to San Francisco via the Pacific and returning by Atlantic, and for the technology on top of Qutub Minar and 6 or 7 lost count also. For my own engineering degrees, which I did just to prove a point. The point is, you can do whatever you want. You can post a growth of 30 to 40%, or you can have the 7 to 8%. You can turn down your organization. You can make whichever achievement is possible. It's all here. All here. Paisa, ye hai. Everything is this. कुछ भी पॉसिबल है करना, प्रोवाइडेड आप सोच सकते हैं, वो उसको ड्रीम कर सकते हैं, एंड यू कैन प्रोवाइड द लीडरशिप टू योर टीम. आई थिंक दैट इज ऑल आई हैव टू से, बिकॉज इफ आई कीप ऑन रिकाउंटिंग इंसिडेंट्स फ्रॉम माय लाइफ, देयर आर सो मेनी दैट द फुल मॉर्निंग हाफ विल गो ऑन. नेक्स्ट टाइम बियॉन्ड लंच लास्ट टाइम आई वेंट टू Indian School of Business, I was talking to the youngsters, I spoke for 4 hours, telling about various incidences, how things happened. Aapko na dodi ka dhaba dekha hoga, dekha how many of you have had food there? Kitne logon ko yaad hai 15 saal pehle dhaba kaisa tha? Us sahi ki halat mein tha, 2500 rupaye roz ki uski sale thi, 2500 rupaye roz ki sale thi. जब मैंने छोड़ा तब 2.5 लाख रुपये रोज की उसकी सेल थी. सरकारी कर्म में, सरकारी मशीनरी में हाथ पैर बंधे हुए 100 times भी इंक्रीज द रेवेन्यू. द मैन हु वाज मैनेजिंग द ढाबा, ही कुड डू इट, ही हैड दैट इन हिमसेल्फ. बट हमको उसको निकालने की जरूरत थी, लाइक द रेस्टोरेंट ऑन द हिल एट भोपाल, द विंडन बीच, 400 रुपये रोज की सेल थी, 2 लाख की सेल पे गया. आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट रेस्टोरेंट्स इन सिटीज लाइक टोडी एंड प्लेस लाइक टोडी एंड भोपाल, नॉट टॉकिंग अबाउट दिल्ली और बॉम्बे. वहाँ पे भी ऐसे ही हो गया. इट वॉज, वो सब चीज़ें पॉसिबल है उस आदमी के अंदर है, उसमें जान, उसको उसकी पूरी बेस्ट निकालने की जरूरत है उसके अंदर से. उसका तो काम खुद करेगा, सरल बनाने की जरूरत है उसकी जिंदगी, उसकी वर्किंग सरल बनाने की जरूरत है, तो सब चीजें हो जाएंगी. अभी आई एम स्ट्रगलिंग विद दिस ग्रेट ऑर्गेनाइजेशन बहुत जरूरी है, जहाँ पे हम चीज़ें चाहते हैं किसी तरह सरल बन जाए अपने आप चले। हम एक ऐसी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन में हैं जिसमें विच इज इन मोनोपोली अकेली इन सेलर्स मार्केट, लोग मरे जाते हैं ट्रेन के टिकट कंफर्म कराने के लिए, फ्रेट ट्रेन के लिए, एंड इन अ कंट्री विच हैज 130 करोड़ पीपल, बेस्ट पॉसिबल बिजनेस सिनेरियो, इससे बढ़िया बिजनेस सिनेरियो नहीं हो सकता। हमको उसको अचीव करना है, उसको उसके लिए इंस्पायर कर रहे हैं, वी हैव टू अचीव दैट, बट फॉर दैट वी हैव टू रिफॉर्म ऑर्गेनाइजेशन। सो ऑलरेडी इंडियन रेलवे इज ऑलरेडी द मोस्ट विजिबल सिंबल ऑफ डायनेमिक डिलीवरी इन अ कंट्री। 22,000 ट्रेन रनिंग एवरी डे कैरिंग 25 मिलियन पैसेंजर्स, 3 मिलियन टन्स ऑफ फ्रेट ट्रैफिक अक्रॉस 8,000 स्टेशन हैंडल्ड बाय 13 लाख मिनट्स। इट्स अ मिरेकल, द बिगेस्ट मिरेकल। दिस फुल ऑपरेशन इज mind blowing, but we can, we are already better than most of the corporates. Unimaginable. I don't, even as a chairman, I don't know what is happening in my sector somewhere. It's autonomous, but it can be still better. It can become as the best organization in the world. Best organization in the world. That is actually we want to come up to the aspirations of India, this emerging nation which is now changing very, very fast. It's rapidly changing. There are miles to go. Tremendous things have to be done. And I believe everything is possible. We can't always have to be hopeful, we always have to be tremendously, tremendously positive under the worst of the circumstances. Pura hall agar bole ki aapka rasta galat hai, agar main feel karta hoon mera rasta sahi hai, मैं उसी रास्ते पे जाऊँ तो मुझे सही लगता है। थैंक यू एवरीवन, थैंक यू ऑर्गेनाइजर फॉर इनवाइटिंग मी टू दिस इवेंट। आई ऑलवेज गेट एनर्जाइज्ड एंड चार्ज्ड अप व्हेन आई लैंड इन मध्य प्रदेश एंड लव द सिटी इन मथुरा। थैंक यू।